We haven't discussed about electrochemical cell. We discussed types of galvanic cell. Now, some conditions we need to discuss before we moving ahead, like conductance, conductivity, resistance, calculation of conductivity, equivalent conductance, and molar conductance. So first of all, we will discuss conductance. Before discussing definition of conductance, we need to know what is the meaning of conductors. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of conductors? Substance which can allow the passage of electricity or current through themselves, they are called as conductors. वो सभी substance जो अपने अंदर से electricity को pass होने देते हैं, they are called as conductors. Basically, they can be present into two different phases. They can be solid, they can be liquid, or they can be present in the gel phase, intermediate phase of the solid and liquid. Conductors can be present in the gaseous state or not. Can anybody tell me ki jo conductors hote hain kya wo gaseous state mein present ho sakte hain ya nahi ho sakte? This is the question of the day. Can anybody tell me conductors can be present in the gaseous state or not? Definitely they can be present in the gaseous state, but we require some specific conditions because gaseous molecules are the molecules, they are very, very low intermolecular forces there. That is why they present far apart from each other, very far apart from each other. That is why it could be difficult to pass the current or to pass the electricity. But if we close the container and fill it with the gaseous molecules or atoms, and we apply external electrical field or external energy source, they can conduct electricity, right? So conductors, basically, they are the medium, they are the substance which can allow the electricity or current to pass from themselves, right? Now we will discuss about conductivity. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of conductance or conductivity? There is difference between conductivity and conductance. Look, conductance basically it is represented by the K, that is kappa we use, right? It is the tendency of the conductor to allow the amount of current or the amount of electricity passing from itself. This is conductance, is the amount of electricity or current passes through a particular conductor. It is represented by the K, kappa. The another definition for the conductance is it is the reciprocal of resistance. What resistance? Each and every conductor have some tendency or have some molecule which oppose the pass of current, the passage of current. These properties called as resistance. Sabhi conductors mein jo molecules present hote hain, they are capable to resist the flow of current. That means they can oppose the flow of current, passage of current. These property, this resistance, called as resistivity. So the reciprocal, yani resistance ka jo ulta hua, that is conductance of a particular conductor. So to calculate the conductance, we use the formula 1 by R, where R represents resistivity. Basically, SI unit of conductance is Simon, which is represented by the S. But we know that conductance can be calculated with the help of resistance. That is why we can use the unit of resistance also. The unit of resistance is ohms. Right? So we will write ohm inverse. So Simon is equals to the ohm inverse. For conductance, we use ohm inverse. Right? Because if we all have different units, resistance, ki, conductivity, ki, sabhi ki SI unit different. If we get the symbol ke form, it can be complicated for us. That is why we use the same terminology. That is ohm inverse. And ohms jo hogi, wo resistance ki SI unit hoti hai. Right? So basically, conductance can be defined as, it is the reciprocal of resistivity of a particular conductance. In other way, we can say that the ease with which electric current passes through a particular conductor, that is called as conductance. Or we can say the tendency by which electric current passes through a conductor, it is the conductance, right? Conductivity, it is the reciprocal of resistivity. It can be calculated as follow. Resistivity is denoted by the symbol which is called as rho. It is called as rho. This rho can be calculated by a formula 1 upon the R. Area of cross section and length of the conductor. Here, R means resistance, rho means resistivity, L length of the conductor, A area of cross section of the conductor. Right? This formula can be written as 1 upon my R, simple conductance. Here C represents conductance and K represents conductivity. The difference is that conductance normally किसी भी कंडक्टर की कंडक्टिविटी या कंडक्टेंस या पावर टू फ्लो द इलेक्ट्रॉन द फ्लो द करंट एंड के दैट इज कंडक्टिविटी इट इज द स्पेसिफाइड टर्म्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पर्टिकुलर एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम दैट इज एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन एंड द लेंथ ऑफ द कंडक्टर दैट मींस दिस इज द स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉपर्टी ये जो K हमने यहाँ पे यूज किया है दैट इज कप्पा हमने जो यहाँ पे यूज किया है दिस इज स्टैंडर्ड क्वांटिटी राइट K दिस इज कंडक्टिविटी C दिस इज ऑल्सो कंडक्टेंस बट द डिफरेंस इज दैट हियर वी डू नॉट मे mention any specified area, but 40K, if we need to define the area of cross-section, the conductance, the concentration, all factors must be standardized. Then we will use kappa, that is K, that is conductivity. This is the difference. Rho is resistivity and R is resistance. Are you getting my point? Now, factors affecting conductivity. For a particular conductor, there are so many factors which can affect the conductivity of a particular conductor. Among them, the first one is electrolytic solution. Koi bhi conductor, suppose we have a conductor which is present in molten state, that is electrolyte. तो इन कंडक्टर्स के लिए बहुत से फैक्टर्स होते हैं जो कि उसकी कंडक्टिविटी को अफेक्ट करते हैं. दीज फैक्टर कैन एनहांस द कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कंडक्टर और दे कैन डिमिनिश द कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कंडक्टर्स. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर दे. अमंग देम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सॉल्यूशन. एज वी डिस्कस बिफोर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स. Electrolytes, let me repeat it. Electrolytes are the salts which are present in the molten state. They can produce ions and they have tendency to pass the current or to show the flow of electron. They can conduct, they can generate the electricity, right? By passing the current. So electrolyte can be of so many types, but basically in a vast area, electrolytes can be classified into two major classes, strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. Strong and weak electrolyte. What is the difference between strong and weak electrolyte? Strong electrolytes are the compounds when they dissolve in a particular solvent, they ionize completely. That means each and every molecule of the electrolyte get ionized and form ions, that is cations or anions. For the strong electrolyte, the amount or the tendency of conductivity is very high. That is, from the strong electrolyte, we can generate large amount of electricity rather than the weak electrolyte. Weak electrolytes are the electrolytes. They can furnish ions, but not completely. When we dissolve weak electrolyte in a particular solvent, they do not completely ionize. Only some molecules get ionized, and these ionized molecules can pass the current. But the remaining molecules do not allow the passage of current because they do not get ionized. These non-ionized molecules interrupt the flow of current. That means they can resist the conductance. That means these molecules which are non-ionized or unionized, they create resistivity. That is why the conductance of the electrolyte totally depend on the type of the electrolytes. That means they can be strong or they can be weak. If we have strong electrolyte, the passage of electricity is easy for us. But if the electrolyte is weak, then the passage of current is quite abnormal, or we can say quite low. This is the difference between strong and weak electrolyte. Some more factors are responsible for the conductance, like temperature. If we talk about temperature, if we increase the temperature, the movement or mobility of the ions increases. Because after getting energy from the higher temperature, it becomes very much visible for the ions to move fastly. Jitni fastly ions move karenge, electric current utni hi zyada fast amount mein generate hoga. If we decrease the temperature, the mobility of the ions decreases, the mobility of the charges decreases, that can affect the generation of electric current. The another factor which is responsible, which can enhance or diminish the electricity or conductance of a particular electrolyte or of a particular conductor, is the concentration. If we get or if we have higher concentration, then the number of ions produced by a particular conductor, we are talking about molten conductors. Those conductors which are present in the molten state, we do not talk about, here we are not talking about solid conductors like metal or wires, right? Here we are talking about molten conductors. That means the chemicals which can, because we are talking about electrochemical cells or batteries, right? For electrochemical cells or batteries, we require molten state conductors, that is chemicals we require. So that is why, and they must be present in the molten state. In that state, they can produce ion and they can produce electricity, right? Here we are not talking about the conductors which are present in the solid state like metals, right? Like copper, iron. So is baat ko aap dhyan mein rakhiyega. So we were saying, कंडक्टर्स की कंसंट्रेशन इतनी ज्यादा होगी, इलेक्ट्रोलाइट की कंसंट्रेशन जितनी ज्यादा होगी, आयंस उतने ज्यादा अमाउंट में प्रोड्यूस होंगे. जितने नंबर ऑफ आयंस और चार्जेस प्रोड्यूस होंगे, उतना ही ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इजीली फ्लो हो पाएगा. सो दिस इज द अनदर फैक्टर ऑन विच कंडक्टेंस डिपेंड्स. नेक्स्ट फैक्टर, ion solvulation. What is the meaning of solvulation? Can anybody tell me? Solvulation, that is dissolution with the solvent particle. As we are discussing, for the generation of conductance, for the generation of electric current, electrolyte must be dissolve in a particular solvent. After the dissolution, they create some ions. It can also be possible these ions can make bond with the atoms or ions present in the solvent or belongs to the solvent. Are you getting my point? If suppose we have a particular electrolyte, we dissolve this particular electrolyte in a particular solvent. Due to the dissolution, electrolyte get ionized or dissociate in different ions. These ions are responsible for the generation of conductance. But the fact is there, these ions get attracted by the ions or atoms produced by the solvents. That means we can say, if there is an attraction between the electrolytic ions and solvent ion, then the ions which are produced by the electrolyte, they get bonded with the solvent ion, due to which the number of ions generated by the electrolyte to produce the or to conduct the electricity, they get decreased. due to the decrease in the concentration of ions generating electric current, obviously जो कंडक्टिविटी होगी या कंडक्टेंस होगी वो डिक्रीज हो जाएगी, बिकॉज देयर इज लॉस ऑफ आयंस जनरेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, सो दैट इज व्हाई द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट जो जनरेट हो रहा है उसका अमाउंट कम हो जाएगा. दिस इज द अनदर फैक्टर व्हिच कैन अफेक्ट द कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. द अनदर फैक्टर, the nature of solvent. Look, we have many types of solvent. They can be dilute, they can be thick, they can be viscous. If we have dilute solvent, then for a particular electrolytic ion, it is easy to move or it is easy to travel through the solvent or through the container, because the density of the solvent ion is less, so jo area jitna bhi occupied hoga wo kam area occupied hoga through the solvent ion, and we have very vacant space for the movement or for the we can say mobility of the ions of electrolytes. But suppose we have a solvent which is viscous in nature. Viscous is in nature, that means they have thick structure, that means they occupy lot of area. If the solvent particles are viscous in nature, that means they occupy large area, they do not provide area for the mobility of the ions generated by the electrolyte. They can interrupt the movement of ions or electrolytic ions, right? If the movement of electrolytic ions get disturbed, the generation of electric current get also disturbed, right? If so, simply we can say if solvents are viscous in nature, they can interrupt the conductance, they enhance the resistivity. Are you getting my point? These are some factors which can affect the conductance of a particular electrolytes when they are present in their molten state. As I told you, how can we calculate the conductivity of a particular electrolyte? हमने इसके पहले जो सो फॉर्मूला देखा था, that is with the help of rho, that is with the help of resistivity, we can calculate the conductance. Finally, we got that formula, that is conductance. L is the length of the electrolytic solution or conductor, and A is the area of cross section, right? इसकी यूनिट होती है ओम इनवर्स. इफ वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट द कंडक्टेंस ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, देन एक्सपेरिमेंटली हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट द कंडक्टेंस ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. फॉर दिस वी रिक्वायर अ पर्टिकुलर सेटअप व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज वीट स्टोन ब्रिज. आई थिंक आप लोगों ने अपनी प्रीवियस क्लासेस में वीट स्टोन ब्रिज के बारे में पढ़ा होगा, मे बी इन फिजिक्स. वीट स्टोन ब्रिज, इट इज द सेटअप बाय विच वी कैन कैलकुलेट द कंडक्टेंस ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कंडक्टर. Let's draw the diagram. इस तरह का कुछ सेटअप होता है व्हीट स्टोन ब्रिज का। जिसमें R3 एंड R4 दो फिक्स्ड रेजिस्टेंस होते हैं